The family which eats together stays together. My name is Nagaraju. I am from Hyderabad. Today, I'll be speaking about the concept of joint family and nuclear family. For generations, India was known for joint families. It used to be the place of joint families, India. Joint family where grandparents, parents, uncles, aunts, cousins, grandchildren used to live under single roof harmoniously. The head of the family used to be the oldest person, either male or female, and used to control the family both in terms of financial matters and in social matters. However, during past two decades or so, the concept of joint family is giving way to the concept of nuclear family, where only parents and children live separately. Why this is happening? There are many reasons. The main reason is due to economic growth, opening up of opportunities. The youngsters in the pursuit of their careers are moving out of their homes to other places. People in rural background, rural areas, migrating to urban areas. And people in urban areas moving to other countries for higher education or for employment, leaving behind the old parents at home. Another reason is the skirmishes which happen between the ladies at home, the daughter-in-law, mother-in-law, over small petty issues, they start quarreling, and these small issues over a period of time grow to full-blown war in the family. As a result, the young family invariably moves out of the home to establish their own family with their kids. One fine day, the elderly people find all their sons and daughters leave them and they are left to fend for themselves. If they are financially sound, physically healthy, they can overcome the situation. Otherwise, they have to face lot of challenges emotionally, physically, financially, socially. If they are not financially sound, they end up either at shelter rooms run by NGOs or run by governments, where their needs are taken care to some minimum extent. There is another section where the elderly people who wants to be on their own even after they become senior citizens. This section normally is well off, financially sound, and they want to be on their own until they breathe their last. So either they ask their children to voluntarily move out of the home, establish, help them to establish their own home, or they themselves go and join retirement homes. These days, entrepreneurs are seeing the business case. They are establishing old age homes, retirement homes, where people who can afford, elderly people who can afford, can join them and live together with the people of same age. And this arrangement in some cases is working like win-win situation for both youngsters, sons and daughters, as well as their parents. In many cases we see children are staying abroad and their parents don't find living with them in the foreign nation convenient. They prefer to go back to their native place and spend their last few days there. So even kids who are staying abroad are finding this arrangement of retirement homes a good thing, and they are supporting financially also for this arrangement. Of course, for people who can afford, this is okay. What about people, elderly people, aged people who cannot afford the high rates charged by the retirement homes? Invariably, they end up at shelter homes, or we find them begging at railway stations, temples, or starving in their homes. What can we do to change this? If we don't act now, the concept of joint family will become extinct. So the way forward is, we should take care of our elders. We should lead by example to our future generation. We should spend at least some time every day with our parents if they are living together with us, or at least call once in 2 days and find their well-being. Unless we act, we'll end up in the same situation after few years. As per 2001 census, the population of senior citizens aged more than 60 years in India was 73 million. This number will become 173 million by the year 2026. Most of us will be senior citizens by that time. So it is imperative that we have to take care of our parents, grandparents, give them dignified life in their sunset years, take care of their minimum needs, feel them wanted, and encourage our children to spend time with them. Then only the concept of joint family will be taken to future generation. Otherwise, within no time, this joint family concept will become extinct. So my dear friends, please ensure you eat together with your kids, parents, sit together and enjoy the meal, and ensure that nobody is on phone or laptop during the meal time. And I strongly believe this will increase the bond between the family members. Thank you. Thank you for watching my video. Good day.